Hey everyone, I recently read about the demon core, which is a plutonium ball that killed two physicists working on the atomic bomb in the mid-40s. That's when I decided to build a radiation monitoring station with mobile alerts. For this project, you'll need a Raspberry Pi, although almost any other single board computer will do, and a GMC 300 or 320 Geiger counter. If you've worked with single board computers, chances are you've heard of balena etcher, but they also provide a platform for easily deploying and managing IoT applications. You'll need to go to balena.io to sign up, and it'll only take a minute. If you have a GitHub or a Gmail account, then you just need to authorize it, and that'll sign you up. Once you're logged in, you'll need to create a fleet. Name it something like Geiger. Pick the default device as Raspberry Pi. It doesn't really matter, you can change it when you actually provision a device. And for the fleet type, you only have one choice because it's a free account, so just click Create. Next, you'll need to flash a microSD card with Balena OS to add your device to this fleet. Click Add Device and select device type if it's different from the default. Production or development doesn't really matter for this project. If you want to use it over Wi-Fi, then you'll need to select that option and enter the credentials. They'll be loaded on the device automatically. Now you can click Flash, but this step requires that you have Balena Etcher installed. You can also just download the image and use any other application to flash your SD card. Etcher will ask you to enter your admin password, most likely. That's to get low-level access to the card. After flashing is done, insert the SD card into your Raspberry Pi and turn it on. At this point, Balena OS is configuring itself, and after about a minute, your newly provisioned Pi should appear under Devices in Balena Dashboard. Next, you'll need to load the application that will do the monitoring. First, clone two repositories. One is a microservice that can talk to the GMC 300, and the other is a microservice that can send messages on Telegram. I'll link both repos in the description. Incidentally, Balena calls these microservices blocks, so I might use the names interchangeably. By the way, if you've never used Telegram, it's a messaging app like WhatsApp. Can go ahead and download it. To connect the two microservices, you'll need to create a Docker compose file in the same parent directory as the two repos you just cloned. You'll also need to modify the GMC 300 block slightly to send the message in the right format for the Telegram block to parse it. That block expects a JSON object, but the GMC 300 block sends plain text. You can either copy what I'm doing here or download it from the repo I linked below. In the Docker compose file, you'll need to enter your Telegram token and chat ID. I'll link how to obtain those in the description and in the top right corner in the cards. And once that's done, you'll also need to install Balena CLI. It's a small command line utility that will help with deploying process. Once you installed it, you'll need to log in by typing Balena login. Then you can just copy the authorization link and open it in your browser. Now, in the directory where you have your code, type balena push followed by path to your fleet, which is just your username forward slash and the name of the fleet that you created earlier. It should take a few seconds to upload and build the code. And after that's done, all you have to do is wait. the two microservices will automatically get downloaded to your device and start running. And in the meantime, you can connect the Geiger counter to the Raspberry Pi using the USB cable. Depending on the speed and reliability of your connection, it might take from a few seconds to a few minutes to upload the code. Then it will be built in cloud. There should be no need to turn on the Geiger counter manually, as the application should do it automatically. I'll be using this ion chamber from a smoke detector to trigger the alert. This one is just done for demonstration purposes only. You should have no need to do it. Once the radiation reaches the preset value, we should start seeing the alerts in Telegram. As you can see, now the high radiation alerts are coming directly to my phone. The frequency of notifications depends on the notification cooldown variable in Docker Compose. You can read more about different variables in the GMC300 block README. Be creative and stay safe.